I'm Jordi Roda. Jordi is George in Spanish, so you can call me George if you have any question. Today I'm going to present a project in which I participated about iBeacons events processing. First of all, I would like to ask if any of you have worked with iBeacons in any project. Today I will try to show you the benefits of using them in your businesses, and also of using the WSO2 products to build an architecture for a system based on iBeacons. First of all, I will introduce you my company, where I work, and our departments, projects. I will put the project in context. I will talk about the iBeacons technology and the motivation of our client. We'll have a glance at the solution architecture. Also the decision criteria for choosing the WSO2 products, and finally some use cases and some future developments we made. I work at Eurocat. It's a center of advanced technology, and it has been just created, so maybe you still haven't heard about it. Our activity is oriented to business. We do a lot of projects and services to cover market needs. We have a staff composed of 700 professionals, ranging from researchers to consultants, and our income this last year was of 50 million euros. These are the six centers that merged into Eurocat. Maybe you know some of them. My former company was Barcelona Digital. It's where this project about the iBeacons was made. And here our areas of knowledge are health, where we develop solutions to optimize the the efficiency and quality of healthcare. Also, we offer expertise in security, about fraud, cybercrime. We have an area of food and environment, where we offer solutions to improve the management of resources like water in a hydraulic system. Also, we have an area of mobility and energy, where we offer solutions for smart cities and the management of energy. And regarding our technology and domains, we do big data and analytics, data mining, machine learning, context and rich services based on GPS or the iBeacons, Internet of Things, security, as I said, information security, cloud security. Also, we offer mobile services. For instance, we offer a platform to test mobile apps in the cloud. The department where this project about iBeacons was made is the technology transfer. Here we offer advice to our clients about the best ways to apply the technology to their businesses. Sometimes this advice involves developing and deploying some solution which we perform, and some other times we develop a pilot project or a proof of concept. We are also able to do the management of the project and coordinating all the parties involved. And we offer also advice about the best way to use the results, either how to protect them or how to publish them in specialized journals or in conferences like the current one. One piece of technology that recently we got our hands on, it's the iBeacons. It's a technology trademarked by Apple. And they work as regular beacons. This is a transmitter that keeps broadcasting a signal, and the receiver of that signal can know its proximity to the beacon. The new thing about the iBeacons is that this signal is sent through Bluetooth, BLE. This is a low energy protocol. It consumes, it has a low consumption of battery, and it's cross-platform. It works well with most of small mobile devices. And they have a range of 100 meters. This is 30 meters. And so they work well for short distances and for indoor locations where the GPS signal is not so good. Their applications go from home automation services to improve the retail shop experience. And how they work? Well, just briefly, they keep sending an advertisement frame that contains these fields, a UID major and minor that identify the iBeacon, and a transmission power that lets you know that your proximity to the iBeacon, which can be classified as near, far, and immediate. Okay, so let's get into our project. This is a proof of concept that we for one of our clients. And they needed to improve the services and sales that they offered in their stores. And they wanted to do it at the lowest cost. And this is taking advantage that their customers, most of them, have mobile devices. And also that the company have their current app. And so we saw that it was a good opportunity to make use of iBeacons because the installation is easy and low cost. Also, they can connect to mobile devices, and we saw that it was one of the typical applications of iBeacons on the retail industry. So we built this system based on the requirements, and as you can see, all the action starts on the iBeacon that keeps broadcasting the frames, and the smartphone receives these frames and send it to business services. Here, the business services do the most important task of our system. This is processing all these low-level events and convert it to high-level events and events with meaningful and with business value. Then these generated events are stored in persistent services into a database, and they are shared with other systems like a notification service and also third-party services. And we also built a user interface for an administrator to do all the monitoring tasks. So, well, in this system, we needed two main components. One is a complex event processor to do all the processing of events. And also, we needed an enterprise service bus because we wanted to build an architecture based on services, and we wanted to have them centralized and integrated. So, there are a lot of products in the market that cover these needs, but we choose the WSO2Cons because of the following reasons. They are open source and they offer a commercial support that it has high availability and quality. And they offer a full suite of products that include the two that we needed, the CP and the ESP. And all these products have a common framework. So the integration it's easy, and they are cloud enabled. So if you want to move them to the cloud, we don't have to modify the architecture. And finally, also we had our previous experience working with their products. So we choose the CEP to do all the processing of iBeacons events in real time. Also, because it offers a lot of protocols and it can handle a lot of protocols and data formats, so it offered flexibility when sharing these events with other systems. And it offers the CD SQL language, so we could define sequences, window time, sliding windows, and So we could evaluate our frames and their changes on proximity over time. And we also choose the ESB because we could connect all our services. Also, we could handle security centralized. So we could securely share our events with other third parties. And it has high performance, so it could handle this big flow of events generated by the iBeacons. So here is a architecture with these two products. In the middle, we have the enterprise service bus handling all the messages, all the events, and redirecting to every system. And here are the complex event processors that would be our business services processing all the events. And also, we have an application server where we are storing all the events on a relational database. Our notification service, sending a notification based on these events. And then the web browser with the user interface and third parties that consume all these events through the enterprise service bus. So let's see one use case to see all these parts working together. Here we have a server processing on the iBeacons frames, one store of our client with two iBeacons installed and that are emitting frames, and one customer with a smartphone that is receiving these frames through Bluetooth and that is passing through the events to the server. And also we have here an administrator, a store clerk, monitoring all of our system. So in this first case, we see our customer that he receives a frame from the iBeacon saying that he's far from the iBeacon one. Then this frame could be sent to the server and he will process it as an input event. And from this input event, he would generate an output event saying that he's the surroundings of the office. And this output event could generate could trigger a notification to our customer, inviting him to come to the store. For instance, he could send a coupon or something to track him to the store. Okay, this is a very simple use case. Now let's see something more complex so we can also see the potential of the CDP and the use of the sequences and sliding windows. Now our customer approaches to the entrance of the store and he receives two frames, one that he's near from beacon one and one that he's far from the beacon two. The server would receive these two events as input events. And by means of a sliding window, finding the time within these two events, it would generate a new output event, saying that the user is at the front door. And this new event could be feedback to our system as a new input event, and by means of another sliding window and a sequence, for instance, saying that it receives three events in a row, it could generate a new output event that saying that the user is waiting at the front door. And this could trigger, for instance, a notification to the store clerk suggesting to attend our customers. So as you can see, the possibilities combining all the events are multiple. And well, although it's a simple project, we are able to obtain a lot of business value out of it. Still, there are some areas to improve. For instance, in terms of security, and regarding the iBeacon, it's very easy for interested parties to capture the events and clone the iBeacon and send new events using the identifier, what is called spoofing. And there are several techniques to avoid that, like rotating UIDs or, for instance, using a secondary location service like GPS. And if we cover these issues, we could implement more interesting use cases. Also, regarding scalability, here the WSO2CP offers different types of distributed deployments. For instance, in our case, we could do a partition of our data by the user that is receiving the events, and then run and deploy each partition in a different node. And also an alternative to an alternative-based system would be using the Wi-Fi. It can also be used to identify the exact location of mobile devices, and normally it's used for location analytics, and it also works very well complementing the iBeacon. So we could integrate both of this technology in our system, just modifying the lowest layer of our processing system. And finally, also we could add post-processing analytics. Just for instance, for the iBeacon events or for this complementary system of Wi-Fi. Here we could use another product of WSO2, the Business Activity Monitor, which is very common to use along with the CEP. And this is a resulting architecture with the Business Activity Monitor. Now the enterprise service bus is redirecting all the events to the complex event processor, which do the real-time processing, and also to the Business Activity Monitor that is doing batch-based processing. And also we have a Cassandra cluster of a database with where we would be storing the events that could be reading the Business Activity Monitor. And finally, I will review some conclusions of this project. We were able to create new business opportunities using the iBeacons, which is a low-cost hardware, and all the cost is on the production of the software, and also on the support, which is necessary to keep the our product in high quality. Also, it's important to highlight that with WSO2, we were able to make an architecture that is scalable and that is extensible with more components. And we also found that this project was a good introduction to our client to the Internet of Things, and to prepare them and to prepare their architecture for this future, more this upcoming scenario.